So we have our vorticity equation in three dimensions. Now we want to write the vorticity equation in two dimensions, which is the equation we'll be working with for our flow geometry. So we have our cylinder in our coordinate system. So this is x, this is y. We're putting the cylinder in the middle of the coordinate system. And right now, I might as well introduce the polar coordinates that we'll be modifying later and using log polar coordinates. So if we have a point here, the polar coordinates then has an angle theta and a distance r from the origin, which is the center of the cylinder, and has two unit vectors, has a unit vector in the r direction, which we call r hat, and a unit vector in increasing theta direction, which we call theta hat, okay? So we have a two-dimensional problem, and I want to write that problem in polar coordinates. So we'll have our velocity field then. We'll have a component in the r direction, u sub r theta, r hat, plus a component in the theta direction, which I'll call u sub theta, which depends on r and theta, and that will be in the theta hat direction. So our velocity field in polar coordinates then has two components, u sub r and u sub theta. Okay, what does the vorticity field look like in polar coordinates? So the vorticity field, omega, is equal to the curl of the velocity field. If you go back to your vector calculus notes, we have the curl of a vector field written in polar coordinates. I don't need to re-derive that here. This is given by 1 over r, 1 over the radius, times d dr of r u theta, minus dur d theta. And there's only a single component, and this is in the direction perpendicular to the plane, so it's in the k direction. So the vorticity field in a two-dimensional flow has only a single non-zero component, which is in the k direction. So I'm going to be calling that the scale of vorticity omega times k. Okay, so omega here is the scalar vorticity. So now let's look at our full vorticity equation and see how it simplifies then in two dimensions. If we look at this vortex stretching term, this omega dot del u term, because the vorticity field has only a single component in the z direction, this becomes the scalar vorticity omega times du vector dz. But the velocity field is independent of the z coordinate, so this is strictly zero. Okay? So this term then, which is so crucial for turbulence, is zero in two-dimensional flow. Okay, so what else do we need to do? Well, we would like to write the gradient operator in polar coordinates. So the gradient in polar coordinates is r hat d dr plus theta hat 1 over r d d theta, okay? And then we need the Laplacian in polar coordinates. So the Laplacian in polar coordinates is del squared is equal to 1 over r squared times r d dr r d dr. So this is one of the many ways you can write the Laplacian, plus d squared d theta squared, okay? So that's the Laplacian in polar coordinates. Again, you can go back to my vector calculus course and lecture notes, and I derived this form of the Laplacian. Okay, now we're ready to write the vorticity equation. There's only the z component. So the vorticity equation becomes d omega dt. So this is now the scalar vorticity. And then the z component here, so it's going to be u in polar coordinates dotted into the gradient in polar coordinates. So r hat dot r hat is 1. R hat dot theta hat is 0. Theta hat dot r hat is 0. And theta hat dot theta hat is 1. So we have a u dot del. So we have a u sub r. U dot del d dr of omega. So d omega dr plus u sub theta divided by r. So plus a u sub theta divided by r times d omega d theta. So that's the u dot del omega equation. And that's equal to nu del squared omega. So it's a nu over r squared. And then we have the Laplacian r d dr r d dr plus d squared d theta squared, all operating on the scalar vorticity. And then this becomes our single equation. So the three-component vorticity equation for three-dimensional turbulence in a two-dimensional flow reduces to a single component equation for the scalar vorticity. A great simplification when you can change three equations into one equation. So let me summarize. We're trying to write the vorticity equation in three dimensions using polar coordinates and a velocity field that doesn't depend on z and also doesn't have any vector component in the z direction. The vorticity, the three-dimensional vorticity field reduces to a scalar vorticity omega that is only in the z direction, in the perpendicular direction. So then we need to only write this equation, the z component of this equation. We make use of the gradient in polar coordinates, and we make use of the Laplacian in polar coordinates. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.